Hello everybody, my name is Aklinox and welcome to another Adrilos video. Today I'll be checking out the top 10 beginner mistakes. So let's start. This is number 10. There is an altar in the game where you throw your heroes in and you get some rewards for it. What you don't wanna do at the beginning is don't use this at all. You don't really need to use altar at the beginning. You will have a 100 backspace. So you can save up to 100 heroes here before you start to using this. So what you wanna do is when you get up to full in your backspace, you can't get more heroes that way. So you wanna altar 1 and 2 stars here. They are only useful for something I will show you a little bit later. And with the 3 stars and 4 stars, you usually don't wanna altar them because by fusing them together here, these are 4 stars and some 3 stars as you can see. You can get a 5 star hero that way. And that's a very good thing. So yeah, that's number 10. Our next beginner mistake is tavern. This unlocks a little bit later, like level 20 I think. So when you go there, you will have 5 quests. If you are free to play, you wanna refresh these. You wanna get a 7 star quest, 6 stars, 5 stars, and at 4 stars, you wanna get the scrolls. Everything else you will be refreshing. This is a very aggressive strategy. See, this is a 5 star quest, so I am taking that. This is also a 5 star quest. This is a good quest, actually, but we are in the early game right now, so we wanna reroll that as well. See, we already got a 6 star quest, that's very good. We will refresh that. Nope. When you have a lot of 7 star quests saved up, you can keep those 4 star gem quests as well. Or if you have more not tickets. If you have more quests with VIP levels, you can keep them. A 5 star arena tickets, I don't really like that. So I hope we can get this done soon. And it's the 7 star. Yeah, see, this tactic works quite good. Yeah, that was lucky, but you get the idea. If you refresh this aggressively, you will get them done easily. Reason we are doing this is, I mean, in the early game, you won't have a lot of 7 stars, so you wanna get them as soon as possible. You wanna complete it every month, the monthly events I will show you right now. We are done with this. So the reason we are refreshing so aggressively is this. You wanna get this done every month. It will give you quite a lot of resources. And by refreshing, you don't really lose gems because you get quite a lot of them back. After that, when you have a lot of 7 stars, you can keep 4 star gems as well. So that's a better way to do it. And this is it, I think. Next up, we have the resources for the game, which are heroic summon scrolls, prophet orbs, and wishing coins. I guess that's all you need to save. What you wanna do is in the beginning of the game, oops. When you have 80 prophet orbs, you can make a loop in the prophet orb event, which happens every month or every 4 weeks actually. So try to get to 8 orbs by completing monthlies, you know, doing dailies and all. There are also some events like Heroic Miracle, which gives Prophet Orbs. So try to complete them, get 8 orbs, then you can use them in Prophet Tree during the event. It's not an event right now, so I can't use them. Yeah, so save them up, do 8 orbs whenever you can during that event. And after you get your first E5 hero, you can start saving your Prophet Orbs for way higher, like you can save up to 400, 500, it doesn't matter. You will be saving them for a pay to win artifact, hopefully, or a good profit orb event overall. And for scrolls, they don't really give much fodder, so just save them up again, up to a point where you can get a pay to win artifact. The current event gives one for 1500 scrolls, I believe. So if we had that, we would be using them, but right now, nope, I'm not using them, just saving them. It's the same for wishing coins. They don't give much of anything really. Just keep saving them for whenever you will need them. Yeah, that is number 8, I believe. So let's get to the next one, which is making fodders. So as you know, these heroes are elite heroes. Take Sherlock, Russell, Porches, and most of these as well. So now if I want to build up my carry, for example, I have the copy for it. And then I will need some fodder heroes, which are gonna be feed into carry and try to get her to E5 slowly. Now if I had these guys as a fodder hero instead of good heroes, I could use them to get carry to E5 actually. But instead I have all elite heroes, so I can't do anything right now. I'm stuck with 10 stars, which is bad. So the best way to do this is only focus on one hero at a time. Make fodder heroes. To make an E5 hero, you need 3 10-star fodders and 3 9-star fodder heroes. So yeah, at the start try doing that. Fodder heroes are usually on the bottom of the list here when you go to the collection and click this one. So yeah, make these heroes to 10-star or 9-star, or even the fodder heroes like Christian. These guys won't be getting to 10 star because they aren't natural 5 stars. So yeah, make these fodder heroes first and then focus on one hero to E5. That's the point. Next up we have the gears, so let's check this. From a lot of places like campaign, you will be getting some gears all around the place. And then when you get them, you can fuse them up to a better gear here in the blacksmith. But you usually don't want to do that in early game because these very low star gears, like the difference is pretty minimal. I mean, if you are gonna use one, you can make one. But other than that, like, check how many I can make here. This is like way too many gears and it's not gonna help you with anything really. So when you get these orange gears, I mean even before that you don't really wanna fuse them together because it takes 3 to fuse up one of these, like 3 of this sort for one of these, and it goes like this all the way. So like if you wanna get this one, you'll be using thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of these swords, so it's not worth it. That's too much gold. You will only waste gold here. Only make these ones if you have the gears here. You can start by here, I think. That's a good starting point. You can upgrade them whenever you get them. But before that, don't worry about these. Let them stack up. Yeah. Next up, we have the monsters. As you can see here, this is our monster part. When you click that, you will have like 9 pets, I believe. 9 monsters. So from here, you wanna choose the Phoenix. Phoenix is the best pet as a starter and like throughout all the game. Like my account is, this one is a 1-year-old account. I'm still only using only Phoenix. It's the best pet that exists right now. So yeah, build your Phoenix first, and then you might, after maxing that out, you might get to like deer or dragon. I guess something like that. But yeah, as long as you get the Phoenix as first, as your first pet, you will be good to go there. Next up, we have the guild coins. So let's see our guild. If you when you log into the guild, you will see that you have six buildings here. With the guild coins you get from settlements, and other places like Altar, Guild War, Ace Championship, does it give? I don't know. Well, doesn't matter. So you'll be getting guild coins. You wanna use them on guild tech all the time. You never wanna use them anywhere else. As you can see, like I have quite a lot here. But that's only really enough to max out one tech. Maybe not even one tech. I might not even do that with that much. So yeah, use your guild coins only in the tech. What else can you do it? Let me show you. You can buy these golden coins, which will give you some heroes or whatever. But like this is a 1-1 trade and it's not worth it. You wanna max out your tech as soon as possible. Which will take years anyway, I think. So yeah, never do this. Just use them in guild tech. You will get gold coins anyway, so it doesn't matter there. Next up, we have the shards. So you have in your bag here hero shards. What you wanna do with them, if you don't have a use for them, just keep them in shards like this. Like, I don't have any use for these 5-star shards right now because I will only open them when I'm gonna make a fodder, make build a fodder, 9-star or 10-star. So I'm just keeping them here. There are some events like Heroic Miracle where you wanna open these shards and it will give you progress in those events. Like this is a 5-star, so if it was a Heroic Miracle, it would give me one progress in that one. There are also some special events where you need to fuse up some heroes in creation circle or just open from back. So keeping things in your back is pretty good actually, if you are not gonna utilize it instantly. And even then you might wanna still save a little bit because you don't wanna miss out on events if it's an easy one. Like Heroic Miracle is very easy, Shelter is also quite easy. Just save some 4-star shards so you can complete Shelter very easily. Again, it's an event that happens every 4 weeks. So yeah, that is it for that. And next up we have the chest. This chest you will be getting from Imp's Adventure and some special events. So as you can see, we have hero chests. You can choose any hero you want from here, other than Light Dark, of course. They have other chests for them. And then you have like skin chest, material chest. All these are good, but you don't want to open them when you don't need them, really. Like imagine if you get a Tix from here, and then you randomly get a Tix from an event. You have one extra copy now, you are not gonna use it. So that means this chest is wasted. Unless you are gonna open them and instantly like E5 and Ignis. Just an example. You don't really need to open them. They're just gonna occupy space in your back. Otherwise, in your heroes, I mean. Like, they're not wasting anything here, so just keep them in the chest until you need them. And next up, we have the Broken Spaces, which is in the Cool Events, Monthly Events, and Broken Spaces. So here you will be fighting bosses. You have some tickets. You get this from campaign. You will be getting rewards for beating these bosses and also for attacking them. So let's see what happens. Just attack with whatever. We killed that one. We will get the rewards later. Let's attack this one as well. And this one. So see, we didn't kill this one. So that's if I use two more tickets, I will be killing this one based on how much I did. You can keep checking how much damage you do with each attack. so that you can utilize your tickets. Because if you attack a boss like 50 times and don't kill it, and then the timer ends, this will restart again. Those tickets are wasted then, so don't attack a boss unless you are gonna kill it for sure. I saw quite a lot of players get this to like 5% and not finish it. That's very bad. You are wasting your tickets and you are also not getting the rewards. Like, if you are that close, you might as well buy some with gems here. Or otherwise, just don't attack at all. And other than that, yeah, I think, let me think about it. You will be getting the rewards in your mail, by the way. So, yeah. I think that covers it. So, that was the top 10 beginner mistakes. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.